Dearly beloved, we are gathered here. Wait a minute. This is the wrong script. I got a funeral tomorrow. My calendar's gotten so busy since I got this preacher's license, I can't keep up with it. Here we go, Haskett Miller. This is a wedding.
Okay, good.
I just met these people like 24 hours ago. I'm still trying to get their names right. We're here tonight to celebrate the marriage of Ann Haskett and Sam Miller. I want to thank each of you for taking time out of your day to attend. Each of you has been chosen because you have made a special contribution to the lives of Sam and Ann. We're asking that you relax and enjoy yourselves and be a welcome participant in tonight's celebration. We want to recognize everyone in attendance as well as friends and family who are not here tonight who have made significant contributions to the lives of Sam and Ann. Sam and Ann met here in Austin during this season 8 years ago. Their love has grown over the years, as has their commitment to each other. They've chosen to celebrate their love with this gathering. And, oh, their vow of marriage, that too. We ask that you, their family, and friends continue to support them as they grow a family of their own. Ann has been practicing and teaching yoga as long as I've known her. She's been studying the last several years to become an acupuncturist. So Ann is trying to fuse her passion with her vocation. I think it's an exciting endeavor. It's something not everyone has the opportunity to pursue. And does Ann have the energy for it? In a word, yes. In two words, of course. Anne has a wonderful abundance of positive energy to bring to whatever she pursues. Sam has been devoted to many things. For 3 or 4 years after graduating college, he devoted himself to becoming anything but a doctor. And he worked hard at it, and he's got some good stories from those experiences. He spent 7 of the last 8 years studying to become an internist. And his first job over the last year, the prisoners of San Quentin have benefited from his knowledge. Throughout their years of study, where they've had very little personal time, Sam and Ann have managed to balance their lives with activities like surfing, climbing, camping, cycling, jogging, and other things. During those years, they've each managed to maintain their positivity both individually and in their relationship. These are people who grasp life joyfully and squeeze all they can out of it. And I think it's a wonderful place from which to begin a marriage. Now, as we turn to the vows of marriage, Sam and Ann would like you, their community of resources, to participate. Do you promise to continue to offer them your friendship and support?
Yes.
As they continue to grow both personally and in their relationship with each other.
Yes. Of course.
Thank you. And do you promise to love Sam to the best of your ability, to support him, to grow with him, to work through difficult times, and to continue to celebrate the joy this partnership brings to you?
I do.
Sam, You down with that?
I am down.
Okay, I thought so, but being a man of the cloth, I need to go over the details.
Sure.
Sam, do you promise to love Anne to the best of your ability, to support her, to grow, to grow with her, to work through difficult times, and to continue to celebrate the joy this relationship brings to you?
I do.
Do you guys have rings to like do
rings.
Something with
you? I think so.
Thank you.
Tight. I know. It's hot out here. Can you hold it?
Yes, I can.
Not the most relaxed I've ever been. I think I got it.
I didn't know which finger.
Thank you.
By the power vested in me by the state of Texas, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss.